the two common categories of investments. One will be equity and the other one will be debts. Now, what are the differences between equities and debt? Let's talk about equities first. When you invest in equity, it's actually you're owning a part of a company, meaning to say you're actually participating in the performance of a company. If the company performs well, meaning if it generates good profits, the value of the investment goes up. If the company did quite badly or reported a loss, then of course the value of investment goes down. So equities are basically participation in the performance of a company as part of the owner. The second part of it is debts. When you invest in debts, it's actually a loan to a company. So when it's a loan to the company, it is regardless of whether the company is making a profit or not so much profit. It doesn't really matter to you. What matters is at the end of the day, the company will repay you the principal and also the interest payment to it. There is also a third category, which we actually call as derivative. Derivative is actually a financial product where the value of this product is dependent or derived from the value of the underlying asset. Next, we go into what is collective investment schemes. Collective investment schemes are products where they actually pool money together from investors and to invest that pool of money. Now, you may ask why we need to pool money from investors. See, in reality, if a lot of investors don't have a lot of money to invest, they don't have thousands available to invest. So the whole concept is you may have 50 ringgit, or you may have 100, or you may have 200. So the whole idea is if you start to pool all this small amount of money together, you may be able to create a larger pool of money. Say, it could be worth 1 million, or it could be worth 2 million, or even 10 million. Now, with this size, you can actually invest to get better leverage and get better exposure to the number of companies you can invest in. There are common types of collective investment schemes that is very common in Malaysia that we are very used to. It's actually unit trust. So unit trust, it is a form of collective investment scheme. So when you pool your money together with unit trust, ultimately the fund can invest either in equity, or they can invest in bonds, or they can invest in a balanced way, meaning to say a portion goes to equity and a balance goes to bonds. Another category of collective investment scheme is closed-end fund, where it's not so common in Malaysia, where in short, it is a listed company, but the purpose of a listed company is to invest in other investments or other listed companies. We don't really have mutual funds in Malaysia. Mutual funds is also a type of unit trust, but differing in structure than unit trust. Mutual funds are mainly in the US market. Recently, there's another type of collective investment scheme that's growing very fast is what we call as ETF or exchange traded funds. Exchange traded funds are mainly a pool of funds that actually invest in other indices all over the world, right? It could be investing in the Japan country index, could be invest in US country index, or could be in US technology index, so on and so forth. So generally, all these products, despite their names, they're all mainly collective investment schemes where the whole concept is to pool money together from various investors into a fund and to invest that fund.